Hello dear friends, welcome to another video of the Never Do Through the GUI, what you can do through the CLI channel. I am Vangelis Prokopiou and today you are watching Rust in the Linux kernel. So I want to make this short video about Rust in the Linux kernel and inform you about some things that happened some days ago. I didn't have time to create such a video and share it earlier, but now that I found the time I did, and I will show you some things. But before we do that, before I show you what I want to show you, if we go to YouTube and search for Rust in Linux kernel, you will see that there are a couple of resources already talking about this. So this is something very interesting already, because major companies like Red Hat, I think this is from Red Hat, or this one, I don't remember, they are talking about using Rust in for the Linux kernel in their modules. So this is the first thing that I want to share with you in this video. But the second thing that I want to share with you, and I don't know how many people know this, is that there was a new mailing list set up at lkml.org by Nick Desalniers, by this guy. So who is Nick Desalniers? First of all, if you search about him, you will come here and you will see that Nick Desalniers is a software engineer at Google working on compiling the Linux kernel with C-Lang and the LLVM, etc., etc. So he's a guy that works at Google and he has to do with the Linux kernel. So what he said in this mailing list is that he's working on putting together an LLVM microconference for the upcoming Linux, etc. But I would really like to run a session on support for Rust in 3, the Linux kernel. I suspect we could cover technical aspects, etc., etc. Question to focus explicitly: are you planning on attending plumbers? So he says that in this conference he would like to have a session about Rust in the Linux kernel. And various guys started answering to this mailing list, and you can see Greg KH answered, etc., and other people. But what we are interested in, for example, Greg KH answered, "Yes, I'll be there, thanks." If you don't know Greg, Greg is a long time maintainer in the Linux kernel. He's a very important person in the Linux Foundation. But what we are interested in is this answer from Linus Torvalds himself. Now he's responding to Josh Triplett, and what Josh said is this: "As I recall, Greg's biggest condition for initial introduction of this was to do the same kind of turn this kconfig option on and turn an option under it off trick that LTO uses, so that neither make all no config nor make all yes config would require Rust until we've had plenty of time to experiment with it." So I'm not an expert myself, but what Josh Triplett is saying is that they should introduced Rust in a, let's say, a hidden way where they can turn on and off and do not affect many things within the Linux tree, the Linux kernel. But this is what Linus Torvalds answers. He says, "No, please make it is Rust available automatic config option, the exact same way we already do the compiler versions and check for various availability of compiler flags at config time. See, etc. And the Rust support should be similar, something like config Rust is available, because I don't want us to be in the situation where any new Rust support isn't even build tested by default. Quite the reverse. I'd want the first Rust driver or whatever to be introduced in such a simple format that failures will be obvious and simple. The worst situation to be in is that small group of people start testing their very special situation and do bad and crazy things because nobody else cares it's hidden. No thank you, Linus. So the response of Linus is that he wants this inclusion of Rust to be very explicit and very clear so that everybody can look at it when the kernel is built, and if there are failures it will be readily available, as you can see with a very explicit flag in the config about Rust is available. So instead of him saying that he wouldn't like Rust in the Linux kernel, we get an answer that implicitly he says that okay, we can have Rust in the Linux kernel, and I want to be very explicit about it. So when I read about this, it was quite a surprise to me, because I know that Linus Torvalds is very keen on using C for the Linux kernel, and rightly so, because we know the advantages that the C language provides, apart from the memory issues, etc. But and I thought that he would not like the idea of having Rust or any other language, of course, included in the Linux kernel. But as we see here, he does not exclude it, but he implicitly accepts this situation and this possibility. So this is very exciting for me. And if we also think the other information that I showed you in YouTube, those presentations by other companies like Red Hat, that they are already messing with Rust and the Linux kernel, things seem like the Rust language will indeed be included in the Linux kernel. And this is, of course, a very positive thing, because we know the advantages that Rust provides. So this is, in essence, the information that I wanted to share. If you didn't know it and you like the video, you can subscribe and thumbs up the video. So this is all that I wanted to share with you. Thank you for watching and have a great day.